New president, check. New general manager, check. New head coach, check. Mark Spector says it's time for the Canucks to shift their focus back to the ice. And the Canucks making it official Monday, making Willie Desjardins the 18th head coach in team history. Desjardins fresh off a Calder Cup trophy win as head coach of the AHL's Texas Stars. Previous to that, the 57-year-old led the Medicine Hat Tigers to 2 Memorial Cup appearances.
Winning so elusive, and so to win that is, it's unbelievable. And then to get a chance to be part of the Vancouver Canucks, like, you know, what are the chances of that? I guess it's been my lucky week. For me, when I looked at what was here, I looked at the two guys that are leading this. I looked at the quality of the players, their personality, what they wanted to do. Canadian market, Vancouver fans. It was the right choice to come here.
Willie D, bit of a departure for the Canucks, who had previously favored big-name coaches with NHL experience like Torts, Alain Vigneault, Mike Keenan, Mark Crawford, thrown into the mix as well, and with much more on the hiring, here now, Darren Millard and the Hockey Central Panel.
A much different feeling at the Norm Jewison Media Room at Rogers Arena, introducing Willie Desjardins than that a year ago when John Tortorella was marched in front of the media. Darren Millard along with Nick Kyprios and John Shannon. Willie Desjardins is a first-year NHL coach. Where is he different than the man he takes over from?
Well, I think Trevor Linden said it best in his press conference, that he connects with the players. And that's basically the strength of, I think, any coach today in this era, with the players that these guys are dealing with on a daily basis. Not to suggest that Tortorella didn't connect with a few players, but the feeling that you had with Tortorella was, it's my way or the highway. With this guy, there just seems to be a better connect with the players as they go through the process together. It's almost like a 50-50. It's a partnership. Not suggesting that he's cut from the same cloth as a John Cooper, but these guys get it today, that you really have to meet the players halfway. You can't browbeat them. You can't embarrass them. Moving forward, there's a true partnership between a coach and a player, and I think Willie Desjardins will bring that to the Vancouver Canucks.
You know what I think of, Darren, is I think when you look at a guy who wanted to coach in a Canadian market, and Vancouver fans for the last 15 years prior to last season saw a team that always was high tempo, was always aggressive, always puck possession, and I think you're going to see a high tempo game back at Rogers Arena when this team goes to camp. They have some great players that can skate. Willie Desjardins' teams, particularly the ones in the American League, did exactly that. They're going to be aggressive on the puck, and they're going to be trying to score a lot more goals than the team that was 29th in the National Hockey League last year.
Desjardins been connected to the Vancouver Canucks for quite some time, so it's no real surprise that he's hired as the 18th coach in Canucks history. But when you look at the total body of that management structure, first-year guys at every level, inexperienced.
Well, I wouldn't put Benning as an inexperienced guy, nor would I put Desjardins as an inexperienced guy. And we know why Trevor's there, because he could be the mayor of Vancouver. The two key guys, the day-to-day guys in Benning and Desjardins, know this game. They know how to talk to people. They know how to make transactions. And to my mind, they're veteran guys that maybe not have had their same jobs. But that, to me, is not a big issue.
Hey, there's a chance that Willie may not win, and it might not have anything to do with how good of a coach he is. You got to be crystal clear, sure, whether or not this roster is good enough for Willie Desjardins to win. And if that's not the case, then the onus isn't on Willie. It's on Trevor Linden and Jim Benning to move this roster forward and get him the players that he can eventually win with.
Just remember what division they're in. They're with L.A., with San Jose, and with Anaheim.
Steep Hill. The front office and the coaching staff, at least with the head man, is filled. Now the job focuses on the draft and, of course, that Ryan Kessler situation.